Now let's talk about the steps that we use for the Biot-Savart law. The steps are very similar to Coulomb's law, except for step number 5, that's an addition. So in Coulomb's law, or in Biot-Savart's law, the first thing we do is choose a coordinate system and define a convenient origin. We then write Rs, which is a vector from the origin to the source. In this case, our source is the current. We then write Rp, which is a vector from the origin to the location where we want to find the magnetic field point. Finally, we find R, or Rsp, which is a vector from the source to the point. That is Rp minus Rs. We also want to find the unit vector and the magnitude, because we'll be using those in the equation. The step that's extra, the step that's in addition to Coulomb's law, is taking our variable I and crossing it with this R vector. I is going to be defined 3 ways, and I'm going to diverge from the way the book writes it so that we can use kind of an abbreviated form. The current can either be a linear current times dl, or it can be a surface current density times ds, or it can be a volume current density times dv. After we have found I cross R, we then are going to apply the Biot-Savart law. The Biot-Savart law that you see here has this current, one of these three, crossed with the unit vector, divided by 4 pi and the magnitude squared. But I like a form that reminds us that the unit vector is R divided by its magnitude, and so we can just take I cross R, 4 pi over R cubed, where we just bring this magnitude down to the bottom. That's the form of Biot-Savart law that I find most convenient. Then the final thing is to integrate our solution. So let's see what each of these steps means. Let's do an example that is just in the xy plane, again for convenience, and let's choose I going in the x direction. So I is Ix in the x direction, and let's say that that is 3 amps. That's a 3 amp source going in the x direction. And it's going to start at x equals 1, and it's going to end at x equals 3, and it happens to be at y equals 2. Then let's first write our Rs vector. So Rs is equal to the vector from the origin, there's my origin, good choice of an origin, to some place here on this source. That is Rs. Rs is equal to Xs in the x direction plus Ys in the y direction. But every place on this line, every place that my current is, I can see that Ys is equal to 2. So I can just substitute that in there. Xs, on the other hand, is not constant. It goes from 1 to 3. But here's my Rs vector. It's a definition of the vector going from the origin to the source, or my current. Now let's write Rp. Rp is the vector going from the origin to the location where I would like to find the magnetic field. Let's say that I want to find the magnetic field any place on the y-axis. So someplace there I want to be able to find my magnetic field. The equation for that vector is xp in the x direction plus yp in the y direction. But we can see that any place that I want to find the magnetic field, xp is equal to 0. So I'm left with only the yp term. Then finding R, or rsp, is equal to rp minus rs, and that is equal to 0 minus xs in the x direction plus yp minus 2 in the y direction. The magnitude of R is found by squaring the terms, so we get xs squared plus yp minus 2 squared and taking the square root. The unit vector, r hat, is found by taking R and dividing it by its magnitude, which is going to give us minus xs in the x direction plus yp minus 2 in the y direction divided by xs squared plus yp minus 2 squared square rooted. We'll continue this in the next lecture.